Good evening. I am Sith Lord Darth Hadeus. And during the weekdays, Fox News anchor Patty Ann Brown. The day after Red Eye's roundtable discussion on the relative sexiness of the Fox and Friends staff, the New York Times erroneously reported that I said, quote, Brian Kilmeade makes me want to puke. In fact, I stated that Kilmeade makes me want to shoop. I'd also like to add that Brian's packed and he's stacked, especially in the back. Brother, want to thank your mother for a butt like that. Straight up, wait up, hold up, Mr. Lover. Like Prince said, you're a sexy mother. And now, meet my first husband.
Once you had a taste of love, then you know you can't take it without it. Love is like a drug that you just can't without. Makes you so excited, makes you wanna shout.
Those were the days. Welcome to Red Eye, the number one show among people who do their own surgery. I'm here tonight with Fox News Channel anchor Patty Ann Brown. She's so hot, the sun wears Patty Ann screen. Andrew Breitbart. Patty Ann, President Bush did not mention Obama by name when he spoke in Israel. Do you think Obama overreacted and overplayed his hand?
Well, he's making it work for him, but the White House insists that they didn't think of him at all. They were actually afraid that people were going to think that they were slamming Jimmy Carter. But since he did bring himself into it, the fact is, he did say that he would meet with Ahmadinejad without any preconditions, and he's still friends with Bill Ayers, and I don't know.
I thought that he was talking about Carter because Carter recently went and met with Hamas.
Right.
That's the conclusion I came to, but like I said, Jamie, I'm stupid.
And are very Gibson-esque.
I'm very Gibson-esque. What could the Gibsons actually do to save Britney from herself?
God only knows what Mel thinks he could do. I mean, you have this guy, a drunk-driving, anti-Semitic, over-the-hill womanizer.
I take offense to all three of those things.
Okay,
keep going.
Photos of him drunk and slobbering over women Britney's age. Yeah. This is the guy who wants to take her to this resort and rehabilitate her.
I don't believe that he's anti-Semitic. I just think he was really drunk and wanted to piss off somebody. That's how
they
I
don't
feel.
Call it truth Greg? Serum for nothing, yeah. though, Greg.
Go, Andrew, quickly. Patty, and what's the worst harassment from a boss you've experienced? And at a previous company, I mean, because none of that stuff happens here, of course.
Of course.
No, absolutely not. Nothing ever at Fox. But no, I'd actually say nothing, because I just don't. I think that guys are just really between a rock and a hard place these days, and almost anything you do can be construed either way. But this woman really was harassed, I think. I mean, I'm just trying to picture you guys with poor Michaela, the only woman who's up there with you all. And what if you did that to her?
Yeah, that would be terrible.
I mean, it's horrible.
If we haven't already. Jamie, did you have Patty Ann, how many old girlfriends still keep in touch with your hubby? And does that bother you?
Actually, none, as far as I know.
Why would he? He has you. Isn't it selfish? I think it's selfish. Andrew, is Patty Ann, how about you? Do you have any friends from prior to the marriage that you keep hanging around?
Yeah, it actually really depends on your definition of a friend. I think that it's fine, especially to stay in touch by email. That's like the safe thing to do. Just find out what they're doing. But
you never replied to my last one, by the way.
All right.
Okay.
Jamie, what do you think? Is it a recipe for...
Patty Ann, you said your husband isn't friends with any of your exes. How about you?
He definitely isn't friends with any of my exes.
Don't avoid the question.
Okay. Yeah, actually, I am friendly with some of my exes.
Really? How friendly?
Not that friendly. We just email, and we'll sometimes get together, actually, with our spouses.
Mm-hmm.
So,
really?
Yeah,
a little hot tubbing.
Sounds a little creepy to me.
A little hot tubbing, maybe?
Yeah.
A little swinging? Maybe a little swinging?
And creepy.
Yeah, you know, I'm a swinger. I am.
Got to
admit it.
All right. James Van Prague.
Andy, let me welcome back all of our guests, Patty Ann Brown, Fox News Channel anchor. If hotness were meth, I'd pay $20 to do her. Andrew Breitbart, Drudge Report editor. Any man knows the key to a woman's heart is to yell at her on the street. And it's that time of year, spring, when catcalling is at its peak. But is it creepy or a compliment? A recent survey found that 98% of women had experienced some form of street harassment. The other 2% looked like Joy Behar. And 30% reported being harassed on a regular basis. Patty Ann, you're a smoking hot, super tasty babesicle. How often a day do you hear it? Does it ever make you laugh, or is it always annoying?
I take offense at that, Greg. I mean, just because I come on this show wearing these revealing outfits, that does not give you the right to objectify me.
All right.
Honestly, I mean, it's ridiculous. And a lot
you
of these
love
women,
it. Well, just admit it, hot pants.
I think that if you dress a certain way and invite that kind of attention, you then can't at least pretend to be offended by it. And I think a lot of these women are out there you know, showing it, and then they're all upset when people come.
You know, you're very kind to sort of placate this pig over here. But in New York, it is bad. I mean, walk into work, and they don't even try anymore. It's the you notice that? Yeah. They don't even do words anymore. Bill, it's like the hissing.
Bill, you shouldn't be wearing a thong at 2 in the afternoon right in Midtown.
I do not like the draft that my skirt usually gives me, so I take it off and just thong.
Yeah, that's nice. Hey, Jamie.
Hey, Patty Ann, I understand your son had a panicky moment at school recently.
Yeah, it was terrifying to him, actually. One of his teachers said, oh, you know, he really has a sparkle in his eye. And he got all freaked out and came running over to me and said, Mommy, Mommy, I have a sparkle in my eye. Get it out! Get it out!
No. Craig did the exact same thing yesterday. It was so adorable.
Did you hit him?
Yeah, like, stupid kid! Dumb kid.
That's how they learn, Patty Ann. That's how they learn.
Yeah, no more sparkle.
That's how you end up with gooners under your bed.
A Gooner, okay. My stunted twin.
Yes. Hey, I got to toss it back. Isn't he on Monday as well?
Yeah, Gooner, my stunted twin, will be on the show.
Excellent.
In a shoebox.
Literally cool. On Greg.
Yes, all right. Bye-bye. You can catch Bill on Fox and Friends later this morning at 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Very special thanks to the wonderful PAB, Patty Ann Brown. Bill Schultz, you disgust me. Jamie Lissa, always a pleasure having you on. That does it for me. I'm Greg Gutfeld. I shall see you next time. I did it.